I want to welcome everyone. First timers, welcome. This is Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi. Welcome you. I'm going to talk to you the topic called Prophetic Intercessor, Time to Pray Against Dreams and Interpretation. And we are dealing with spiritual warfare, whereby many people, they don't understand this. Some churches, they don't preach these things. So I'm talking to you so that God can help you. I'm going to share with you from the book of 2 Corinthians. Yes, my sister. Thank you so much. Yes. Yeah, thank you. I'm going to read from the book of 2 Corinthians 10, verse 3 to 4. 2 Corinthians 10, 3 to 4. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, I want to thank you. I thank you this time. I bless you. I give you the glory, the time of intercessor, the time of praying, the time of interceding, Lord, my Father. This time, as I'm going to talk this topic, Lord, I want to thank you and praise your name and give you the glory. My Father and my God, give us understanding and revelation about these scriptures so that your people can be, their ears can be open and their eyes to open God. My Father, I want to thank you. Thank you for the people of Periscope and Prayerline and people who are watching me in Twitter, Facebook, and all of the medias where they can access and watching me. Thank you, Lord, thank you for the people you bring. Lord, I pray for them, my God. You know their needs, you know their heart, and I pray that, God, you will deliver them and you meet their needs, Lord, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians 10, chapter 10, verse 3 to 4, the Bible says, For although we walk in life in the flesh, we are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh, and using human weapons. For the weapons of our warfare are not physical weapons of flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of stronghold. The Bible says, although we walk in life in the flesh, although we walk flesh, we are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh. We are not carrying our warfare according to flesh. We are not using the flesh and using human weapon. We don't use human weapon. We don't use knife. We don't use guns. We don't use physical fighting and blood. We don't fight blood and flesh. Our warfare, we don't use blood and blood and flesh. We don't take something to throw to a person, because when you get these dreams, the dreams comes to you in the spiritual realm, in the kingdom of darkness. They come at night when you are sleeping, when you are not aware. So the same way that dreams come is the same way we will attack them, because our warfare are not flesh and blood. So our weapons are not flesh. Now, when you wake up, you found a dream, you don't know what you are doing, you started worrying, and you start thinking what you can, you don't know the meaning of the dreams. So, because of that, I am going to talk to you and explain to you further. Once you understand this scripture, first of all, we are not fighting blood and flesh. We were not fighting, our weapons are not flesh and blood, but they are mighty before God for the overthrow and the destruction of stronghold. Our warfare are mighty. They are mighty before God for the to overthrow and the destruction of stronghold. every stronghold, any damage that enemy has done, we will bring them down. So the Bible says in Colossians, this is Paul talking, in Colossians 2, verse 15, the Bible says, God dismantled the principalities and powers that were raged against us and made bodily display and public example of them in traveling over them in him and in it, the cross. So God dismantle every satanic dream, every evil dreams, anything. The Bible says God dismantled the principalities and the powers that were raged against us and made bold display and public example of them in troubling over them in him and in it in the cross. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. So God dismantled, you know, God disarmed the principalities and powers that were raged against us. So the Lord disarmed, dismantled, destroyed all principalities. If you look at your Bible, that word, the other Bible says dismantle, other Bible says disarmed, other Bible says destroy. So it is all destroyed. The God dismantled, disarmed the principalities and the powers. God destroyed the principalities and the powers of every satanic dream, of everything that is working with Satan. Made bold display and public example of them in troubling over them in him and in it, the cross. Now, for example, if you find yourself sexual intercourse in dreams, this is a very common warfare dream. But since most people find it embarrassing, they usually will not talk about it. There are two spirits the enemy sends against men and women. So this spiritual warfare, it is common. Most people, they get dreams of sexual intercourse, but they, because of embarrassment and shame and disgrace, so you find you can't even talk about it, you can't share, you just keep it. But in the real thing, it affects people. And these are the spirit. They come in a spirit. They are two spirits the enemy sends against men and women in the dreams. The first is known as spirit husband. Spirit husband, which is a spirit that sleeps with the women in their dreams. The other is spirit wife, which is a spirit that sleeps with the men in their dreams. This spirit may use the faces of ex-lovers. If you had an ex-boyfriend, your ex-husband, your ex-wife, that's what this spirit uses. They use familiar spirit, the spirit you know, like your ex-husband, your ex-boyfriend, your ex-wife, friends, or a surgeon, even the pastor, familiar. They may even come as people of same sex. Sometimes they come, you know, people call me and they tell me these things all the time. Sometimes they can use same sex. Unless you wake up and wage war, serious spiritual warfare, one all of these following may take place in the life of the dreamer. That's why we were reading this scripture from the book of Colossians 2 verse 15 and 2 Corinthians 10 verse 3 to 4. Because this is the only way you can tell the devil. You can tell the devil when you found that you've been in contact with the sexual in the dream. You can tell the devil, God dismantle or disarmed the principalities and powers that are raged. That is against us, against me. You that dreams I dismantle you, I destroy you, I cancel you, I cut you off. You wake up very serious, wherever it is. So when you go with the serious spiritual warfare prayer, it will stop this enemy that is coming to attack you. You find it when you are being attacked by sexual intercourse in the dreams, you find it difficulty getting married, difficulty mountain problems, difficulty getting pregnant, difficulty in the area of finances. Those demons, they are the great enemy of you getting married, difficulty marital problems. Your marriage will be in a wreck. You will suffer. You'll be married, but you will not enjoy your marriage because these spirits are there and they are coming to take over. It can make you not to get pregnant. Some women, you can't give birth because they don't want children. They want them. They can make you having financial difficulty, really very hard time of finances. They take everything. They are very jealous. Spirit husband and spirit wife. When you encounter a sexy intercourse with them at night, you will find very difficulty to stay your marriage and even to have money. It is very difficult. They are called spirit husband and spirit wife. They are from marine kingdom, from the water. I will talk to you about that in next, maybe tomorrow or another time. Dreams that result in affection with the spirit of poverty. The dreams that result in affection with the spirit of poverty. There are so many people today suffering seriously oppression from the spirit of poverty. Usually people are attacked of in their dreams because of lack of knowledge. Nothing is done until manifestation takes place. If you find yourself in the following situation in your dreams, you need to start praying against the spirit of poverty. You may see like this: possession of counterfeit money, wallet stolen from you, wearing rags, shoes with holes, begging for money, food extra, loss of cash, wallet, checkbook or paycheck, bank door closed in your face. This is a very serious poverty. You need to start praying against spirit of poverty. When you see these things, you don't have to sit down. You have to rebuke it and cancel it and render them powerless. Many times you may see your wallet being stolen, your handbag being stolen, your shoes with the holes, begging for money or counting coins like silvers, coins, change. You don't need that. That is poverty. You come against the spirit of poverty in the name of Jesus. Sometimes you see yourself naked in the dreams. If you find yourself naked in a dream and you look for clothes to cover your nakedness, the enemy is about to bring embarrassment and disgrace, shame into your life. If you find yourself naked in a dream, you need to search your life to see if you are involved in anything that can bring embarrassment and do something about it immediately. Sometimes you can search yourself if there is any door or something that has happened to you. If you don't know, if you cannot think of anything, you need to bind every spirit of the enemy to embarrass you and disgrace you or to put shame on you. Because you remember, I said early in the other video, the Bible says, he who believes in the scripture will never be put to shame. Therefore, when you find yourself in this situation and you think you can't find why anything, but you know the enemy wants to bring disgrace, embarrassment, and shame, so you rebuke them. You quote the scripture from the book of Romans 10 verse 11. Says, I believe the scripture. Therefore, I believe the scripture. I will never be put to shame. Every embarrassment, I render you powerless. I destroy you. I come against you. Every spirit of disgrace, I am standing against you. So you refuse. because nobody needs embarrassment. You don't need that. Therefore, the enemy wants to embarrass you. So that you can stop them. You have to stop them before they stop you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Removal of hair in the dreams. You see your hair is being removed in the spirit, like somebody's coming to cut your hair or plait your hair. That one is attacking your glory. In a woman, your hair represents glory. And as the removal of it in a dream is very significant, you need to pray against your glory being tampered with by the enemy. So you know, as a woman, your hair is your glory. And if the glory has been taken, then you have nothing. You don't have anything. So you have to come against the enemy. You have to command that enemy to return your glory. You have to bind the plans of the enemy to embarrass and disgrace you and to take your glory. You need to pray against glory being tempered by the enemy. You command the enemy to stop temper with your glory. You command the enemy, you the enemy of my glory, I destroy you, I bind you, I render you powerless, you will not manifest, return my hair in the name of Jesus. Even you can need to call fire. You cut that pipe, I can't pronounce properly, but you know what I'm talking about. You command them to be destroyed. You cut them completely in the name of Jesus, by the power and the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, you command that hairdresser, the one who is cutting or plaiting your hair, satanic hairdresser, you cut their fingers, you cut their hands, you cut them, you cut their blades, you set them ablaze. Even the machine they are using, you destroy them, you set them fire, so that they cannot take your glory. In the name of Jesus. Dreams that indicate witchcraft activities. There are dreams that indicate witchcraft dreams, activities. Being pursued by mentally drugged a person. You are being pursued by mental deranged person, a mental person chasing you, or attacked by dangerous animals. When you see dangerous animals like bulls, very angry and dangerous animals, being shot with gun or arrows in a dreams, feeding pressed down on the bed and unable to get up, even when wake up, bad beds. This usually indicates that hypocrisy are going to be set loose against you. So, cobwebs and spiders, these are other arrowy favorites, point to contact of witchcraft. Let me repeat this very clear. Some people, they are not aware of this. When you are pursued by a mental person just pursued you, they chase you, they want to attack you, or you are attacked by dangerous animals, a group of animals attacking you, you see them coming to you, being shot on with guns or arrows in a dream, feeling pressed down, you feel like somebody's pressing you down on your bed and unable to get up. Even when wake up, you see bats. This usually indicates that hypocrisy are going to be set loose against you. Those are witchcraft activity working against you. The cobwebs and spiders, these are another arrowy favorite point of contact with witchcraft activities. It is not usual for such a dreams to wake up and literally run onto cobwebs all the days. When you see all this, you have to call fire. You know fire is the best that it can help you to destroy the works of the enemy, the works of the witchcraft. Remember, the Bible has given us authority. The Bible has given us authority and power against witchcraft. So there's no way that you can live a witchcraft, because the Bible says, suffer not a witch to live. These signs, when you see them, you have to declare a war against witchcraft. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus. Don't want destruction again. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Yes. You are a God. You are a good God. You know that the enemy is very jealous when you talk this topic. Yes, Lord, I thank you. Dreams that indicates attack of prophetness or and confusion and confused life. You had it, you see? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I bless your name. I thank you. I'm telling you, the enemy is very jealous. He's defeated. He is a liar. So when you see dreams that indicates attacks of prophetness and confusion life, you work very hard, but you got nothing. You can do even 3 jobs, but you don't have anything. You don't know what is happening with your money. During when you are getting the check pay, your check is already taken, and you are not aware. So when you dream something like that, you have to come against eaters. You have to come against a satanic bank manager. You have to pray a prayer called satanic bank manager. I destroy you. I curse you. I remove you from your possession. I destroy you, and I command you to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You sack that satanic bank manager from the position, and you set that their bank fire. You command that bank to be set fire in Jesus' name. Yes, that's why you know that you use a lot of fire in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my sister. Yes, hallelujah, thank you. Yes, hallelujah, yeah. Sorry for that. Anyway, I cannot respond to you what you are saying, because I'm concentrating on prayer. So if you are saying hello or you are commenting, thank you, I will feel it later. For now, thank you for those who are joining. And I want to really concentrate, and I want to pray for you, so that maybe I'm not offending anybody, but I really appreciate your comment. And I call me or talk to me another time. So I thank you so much. Yes, traveling but not reaching your destination, traveling to an unknown destination, traveling in a fog or in a crowd or dust, it means that the enemy as planning heaviness, all he has planning, yeah, as make you not to see your future. Hallelujah. You have to come against roadblock enemy. You command the road, that satanic roadblock, to bear the way in the name of Jesus. When you are traveling but not reaching your way, your destination, traveling to unknown destination, traveling in a fog or in a crowd of dust, the enemy has put a roadblock on your way. So when the enemy has put a roadblock, now you can't go anywhere. You are like stagnant. You are lounging, circling yourself. So you have to come against satanic roadblock, satanic blockage. You command them by the power and the blood of Jesus. I destroy you. I cut you off in the name of Jesus Christ. You stand against them. You have to rebuke them and command them to get out of your way in the name of Jesus. Let the blood of Jesus pave the way in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Dreams that indicate warfare of delay. Waiting for a bus, tax, ship, train, airplane, or any mode transportation that never comes, traveling in a traffic hall, almost there. These are the almost there, never there. There are people who whose lot in life seems to be that just before they get something good, it is snatched before them. So some people, they wait something which takes people like 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 1 hour. With you, it will take you hours or months or years. That's how it is. So you must command that spirit to give you away in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, my God, I want to thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, the spirit called almost there, but never there. There are people whose lot in life seems to be that just before they get something good, it is snatched from them. Such a people are under attack of what we call almost there, but never there. Such a people have dreamed along this line, waiting in the tax, waiting in the bus stop, waiting transportation, but you never get it. Waiting for a bus, taxi, ship, train, airplane. That is the spirit of almost there, but you never there. Not finishing examination before time expire. Doors closed before they get inside. Free gifts finishing before it gets to turn to your turn on the discontribution line. This in the real life, those who have such dreams would have hard time attaining their goals and hard desire. If you see you are not finishing your exam, if you see yourself the door closed before you get in, and then this will take you long time. In the real life, those who have such dreams will have a hard time attaining their goals and hard desire. It will take you time to achieve anything. That's why you see some people, they do exam, they will never pass the exam. They can repeat so many times. I remember a lady came to me. She was doing driving school. She tried the test 19 times. She never passed the test until she came to me, and after the prayer, she went there the first day she got her driving license. I have another, a man, a pharmacy. Her pharmacy has been doing the test for license. He never passed his test, licensing test. All the time he was repeating so many times, so he was given the last one, the last chance. And then they can cancel him completely. So he came to me when he was down. He didn't know what to do. He told me that I have the last chance. I don't know. If I fail this test, then that is the end of my pharmacy. This is the end of my life. I told him, bring your certificate. Bring all your certificate, your degree. I will pray and the Lord will help you. You will pass the test. So the man brought his own the degrees, the certificate. I lay my hands, I anointed, I prayed. The man passed his test. He's now a pharmacy. He was hired. He passed the test and he got the job straight away. He got the job. Another person is a doctor. The doctor that I give you a testimony every time. This doctor, she was here for 7 years and she tried to pass exam. She was not able to pass exam. After the prayer we did, she was able to pass exam and now she's working. I'm telling you that when you see these things in the dreams, it will make you to go a long way. But through the grace of God, God is able to cancel them, to destroy them. Because always God gives you a warning. But because you don't know what you are doing, so it happens. I was talking with a doctor. And this doctor was telling me that she has been working, she has been trying, she wants to specialize in another area in doctor, in the hospital. But this test, she wants to do it, she has been doing many times. Until now, she's almost giving up. Then she asked me, do you think is witchcraft or what is that? I said, it will be both. Why can't you pass? If you pass your degree, you pass everything, you are a doctor, now you want to specialize something. Don't you see something is not right? And because you, and she said she had been dreaming the dream like the one I was saying. So I told her that there's a way out. We will pray, then God will help you. So I'm praying for this doctor. Also, God will help her. I have seen those who almost get married but never do. Almost get a job but never do. Almost pass an exam but fail by 1 or 2 points. Others have jumped from one business venture to another and from another profession to another. When I was doing a consulting human resource, we were hiring, and I used to scan the resume people were sending to us. I used to see people, they've been working in so many places, so many companies. They work in 6 months, 2 months, 1 month, they leave the place. So they have been wandering from place to place. You find a person has good papers, very good degree, but they've been wandering from place to place. They can't stay in one place. You've seen some people like that. Even right now, a man called me from Kenya. He is asking a university degree, but this person, he doesn't work in a place. He works only the 3 months. He doesn't exist for 3 months, 2 months, 3 months, and he gets big jobs. People hire him, but he can't stay in the job. He runs away. Yes, that's the dream of sitting in the examination, but you never finish. Dreams that indicate attacks against dreamers' spiritual life. When you have the dreams attack against dreamers' spiritual life, generally these dreams should alert the belief to the fact that the enemy wants to downgrade their spiritual walk. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Smoking or consuming alcohol in the dreams, eating in the dreams, this is usually followed by a period of weariness, tiredness, and rest in prayer. Just as physical food weighs down the eater physically, so does this weight dreamer down spiritually. Drinking and bathing in the dirty water, this is something not spiritual and even physical portion. Rules of Bible. So dreams that indicate rules, having a portion in a dream, losing blood in a dream, take to an familiar location or abandon. These dreams foretell or rules of intimate friends and a good relationship. They have also resulted in rules of favor in the life of many dreams. So we have to pray against them in the name of Jesus. I am going to pray. There are so many. I can't finish them to talk to them because I have to come again. It's 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock, I'm coming for another prayer. Let me see how far it will go. Initiations in dreams. Initiated in dreams. Many innocent people have slept only to wake up initiated into various demonic society as a result of dreams they had. Pray particular attention to these dreams. If there's some dreams that initiating people, you might become a witchcraft, blind witchcraft. You are not aware you are a witch, but you have been initiated in the dreams. That's why you find the Bible said rebellious is like a witchcraft. So when you rebel, that is a witchcraft spirit. You were not like that. You just found somebody changing. A good person now has become very stubborn, become rebellious, become very rude. So you wonder what happened to this person. The person has been initiated witchcraft in the dreams. And from that, when you become rebellious, even the church, it is very difficult to start going to church, even prayer. That's when they attack you. When they initiate you in the dreams, you found that you start losing prayers, you don't attend prayer, you don't read your Bible, you find yourself, everything you are doing is difficult. Even the church, you excuse yourself. It's the time for the church, you are sleeping, or you find something else, or you just go to work. You decide to get a shift. I'm not refusing those people who are working Sundays, because if police cannot work Sunday, how are we going to do? If the doctor cannot work Sunday, how are the patients going to have? So, but you find the enemy, when he initiated you, He makes you that you don't have a chance to pray. You don't have a chance to attend the church. You don't have a time to read even the Bible. Even your own Bible, when you are at break time, you can read the Bible. It makes you that you lose interest completely from the Word of God, so that they can get you full and use you. Finding yourself in a strange meetings, eating strange food with strange people, swimming in the water with strange people or strange creatures, getting married to the strange husband in dreams. So these are the witchcraft meeting. You are attending witchcraft meeting without you aware, because these are all strange meeting. They come in at night while you are sleeping. They pull your spirit and they make sure you are attending. You start swimming with them, and because of that, they marry you in the spirit. The spirit, when you are married in the spiritual world, whether you like it or not, if you don't get spiritual warfare prayer to break that, you will die like that. You will never be married, because already you are married in the spirit. So that you need the prayer of cancel and destroy. You kill that spirit husband. You command them to die. You take the ring. You put it in fire. They ground everything. People, they get dream like that. When you get dream getting married to a strange husband, that is not the real. Unless you are a prophetic dreamer, if your dreams are prophetically, that will happen. But if not, then you are married in the spiritual world. If spiritual world, you can never be married. Even your own husband, they will kill your husband and marry you. Therefore, you have to be careful with your dream. Contact with the dead, Many dreamers can find themselves having contact with their dead relatives, ancestors, and friends. I've heard of people who even pray for such dreams. So anytime you get contact with the dead relatives, that is ancestral spirit. They don't want to leave you. They count you like one of them. So they cannot leave you. Everything is dead. Anything you are doing is dead. So they will make sure that they are damaging you. The Bible tells us the dead we don't associate with the dead. Once the dead is dead, the Bible says we don't talk with them. They have gone. So we don't have time. We don't have to see them or to talk to them. They have nothing. They are dead. Everything is shut. So they cannot even talk to you. When you see them, that is familiar spirit to come and attack you. Therefore, you can pray very hard to stop them and cancel and pray the prayer of ancestral in the name of Jesus. The living has nothing to do with the dead. The power of darkness have been known to utilize such dreams to transfer sickness, diseases, unto the life of the dreamer. In many cases, it turns out of the same sickness that killed the person that dreams about. So that's when they initiate you. They call you like you are one of them. So the sickness that kill the relative, the person, it will transfer to you. It will kill you the same disease. That's why you see the family says that cancer is in our family. Because cancer has been killing people in your family. So when they come to you, they initiate it. They give it that sickness. You accept it. You cancel it. You render them. You command them. I am born again Christian. I'm a child of God. I don't have anything to do with your sickness, with your diseases. You cannot affect me with any sickness in the name of Jesus. You refuse it in Jesus' name. You cancel it. Even more serious, such a dream have been exposed to familiar spirit through such a contact. To take for an example, a dream a lady related to the deliverance minister. She had the dream 20 years before. In the dream, she saw a man who resembled her dead father, submerged in the ground. Only his head was about the ground level. She went towards him in order to rescue him from his predicament. As she ran towards him, she dropped and fell her head, went unto the wide open mouth of her father. She succeeded at pulling her head out, but her father held on to her hair with his teeth. The struggle continued for a while. It stopped when somebody came, wrapped her in a white linen, and pulled her out of the mouth of her father. Then she woke up. So you see, the sister had a dream many years ago, that she saw the father sinking or drowning, and then she went to rescue the father. When she went to rescue the father, she also drawn in, and then after she drawn in, she managed to come out, but the father held her hair until she prayed very hard, she struggled very hard, until the person came, who was Jesus, to rescue her. If she didn't know spiritual warfare prayer, she could have died. She could not wake up because she was struggling. That is familiar spirit who came to take her life. That's why you see many people, sometimes a pastor woman here in Brampton, she was sleeping. She never wake up. One of her members who comes to our prayer, she told us that the pastor, she went to sleep, she never wake up, she died. Some people, they die like that. But when you know the spiritual warfare, the immediate thing you can do is to bind that spirit and cast them. Therefore, people of God, I want you to be, the Bible says, we are not ignorant of the schemes of the devil. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, I thank you, Father. How do you classify a dream like that? Obviously, it was a bad dream. That has nothing to do with the way she spent her day. Therefore, she had to be under a serious spiritual warfare. See, she father told me, Pastor, from the day I have had non-stop headache and throat and dizziness, I often feel as if someone is pulling my hair. I have been many doctors, no value. It might be significant to remind you, dear leader, that one she saw in the dream might not have been her father. You know, my friends, my dear friends, I want to tell you that was a familiar spirit, or that was programmed by the enemy to do that, to attack her with sickness. When you see these dead people, relative, don't leave it like that. Don't be ignorant. Don't say that my father or my mother came and talked to me in the dream. Your mother will never talk to you. That is familiar spirit. That is demon. She died. The Bible says they, you don't have anything to do with the dead. The dead has gone. It's dead, you know, it's dead. So how can a dead person talk to you? The Bible says they are sleeping. So they cannot wake up and start talking to you. That's a lie. Therefore, the enemy could have used the face of her father to get close to trap set for her. That was a trap. That was a snare. Snare that was put there in the face of the father, so that when she saw the father is drawn to go and help her. The familiar spirit satanic can bring the face, you see, like they can bring a pastor or somebody you know close. When you go to risk, that is the end of your life or the end of your family. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray you will not be a portion of that. In the name of Jesus, I destroy them. I render them powerless. Let them die. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, yes. Attacked by armed robbers, such dreams denote the existence of serious obstacles in the life of a dreamer. Roadblocks and padlock. These dreams can contain law enforcement, law, roadblock, or tree falling across a pathway. Such dreams significant blockage in the life parts of the dreamers. Hallelujah. Handicaps indicate restriction in the life of a dreamer. Climbing mountains and hills. Such dreams point to the presence of obstacles and influence in the dream's life. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. I pray that God would deliver you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God, my Father. I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, I pray that God would destroy every satanic dream, every evil dream that is waiting to manifest. I am praying at them. I cancel them, everyone, in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will destroy every satanic dream, every witchcraft dream, be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I pray that God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, you are a God. You are a God. You have given us power. You have given us power in the name of Jesus Christ. We are not fighting against blood and flesh. We are not fighting against breast weapon. We are fighting God with the mighty God, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. I stand before you, God. I worship you, God. I thank you. I give you all the glory, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. I thank you, my God. We are not walking in flesh. We are not carrying on our warfare according to the flesh and blood. We are fighting the enemy. As the enemy comes in a spirit, we also go in a spirit. Therefore, I take the authority by the power and the blood of Jesus to destroy and dismantle, to render them powerless. Every satanic dream, I command them to die. They will never function in your life. In the name of Jesus, I destroy satanic dream. I render them powerless. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my heavenly Father, you are God. There is no another God. We depend on you, Lord. Destroy every satanic dream that has been programmed, manifesting in the life of the people. People, some people, they don't know their dreams. Even they forgot. They forgot their dreams. Father, I pray that every forgotten dream started coming to manifest in the life of the people. I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. I call fire of God to burn to ashes every satanic dream, all evil dream, all dreams that is attacking people in the name of Jesus. Fire of God, burn them to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Good dreams that our Heavenly Father has given us, let them manifest like the dreams of Joseph that promote Joseph from a prisoner to a prime minister. The dreams like the ones Esther had, the dreams that Daniel had, the dreams of promotion, the dreams that would prosper, let them prosper. Every satanic dream, every witchcraft dreams that has been attacking the people, your people, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. The dreams of Joseph, the dreams that Joseph had and Mary, let them come upon the life of the people. The dream of destiny, the dream of visions, like the dreams that Peter saw, the visions in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the dreams come upon your life. Father, I pray that those people who does not dream at all, I pray that their dreams be activated in Jesus' name. I want you to pray one prayer point, praying like this. My dream life, receive fire. My dream life, receive fire. Just pray like machine gun. Just pray for your dream to receive fire. Wherever satanic dream come, fire will take over and then it will destroy them. I want to activate your dreams. At the same time, I want you to start dreaming. If you don't dream, it is very dangerous. It is so dangerous. You need to dream. Now I'm praying for you. You pray with me like this. My dream life, receive fire. 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 In the name of Jesus, I pray that let your dream life receive fire. All those attacks from the dreams, I destroy them. I condemn them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost fire, enter into your dream. Pray, Holy Ghost fire, enter in my dreams. 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 Repeat that prayer. It is a very powerful prayer that you can pray for your life about your dreams. When your dreams catch fire, there is no demon that will bring the dreams. You will be seeing good dreams, the dreams of promotion, the dreams that bring good things, the dreams of prosper. Not satanic dreams that bring sickness, bring diseases, like the woman what she saw. Afterwards, she started feeling headache and suffering. She visited doctors upon doctors. Nothing was happening until this woman came and she was delivered. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, everyone who is battling with dreams, every satanic dream, evil dreams that is molesting you, I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless. I pray that let your dream receive fire. Let your dream be delivered in the name of Jesus. I thank you and I bless God for you. Remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Also, call me if you need me to activate your dreams, to pray for you about dreams. I have so many videos about dreams, but if you want me to speak the word in your spirit, call me. My number is 905-487-7196. Or you can reach me by text message 647-608-5207. We have a free number, long distance. If you are from States, North America, you can reach me this number, 877-241-34220. Yes, thank you, my sister. Thank you, Sister Deborah. Thank you for what you are doing. And also remember to give to our ministry. If this ministry is blessing you, go to our website and donate. Also, if you are living in Brampton, Toronto, around the GTA, you are welcome to come and attend our meeting Friday, deliverance meeting. We have prayer meetings 7 o'clock every Friday. You are welcome to come and join us. This is your host, Reverend Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. See you 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock, 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. I think 8 o'clock is better. I will come again 8 o'clock. Thank you very much. God bless you. The video of yesterday, Dr. Juma was giving a testimony about the training, Overcomers Deliverance Training School. You can go to the website. The video is there. It's in the Twitter. The video is in everywhere. It's in Google Plus. You can go and view it and listen it, the testimony. And if you want to join the school is open. It is on your own time. If it is free, you can join anytime you want. So, and it's 101 teaching. I have so many students coming. That's why I'm saying I will come in 8 o'clock. I have a class immediately after this. So God bless you so much. Have a wonderful time. See you 8 o'clock this evening tonight. And have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye.